to share another video with you from my California travel album that I've been working on. So, to be honest, like, the first half of the album was feeling super inspired. Second half of the album, I struggled. And I didn't film a lot of it because I felt like I was just filling in the pockets and nothing creative was really happening. Like, in the beginning, I had a lot of really fun stuff. I was kind of creating the themes and, like, kind of finding, like, title pages and things as I went. And so the last video I shared with you was me talking about how I, like, stage, excuse me, how I stage an album where I kind of get things filled in before I make, like, official determinations on what embellishments are going to be on there. So I've worked on this set of my day seven processes, filling things in, and I'm still staging things. Like, this is tucked in and not officially glued down, but these are, this is all I thought was complete. So, like, I was really enjoying doing this part. Like I said, felt like I was just filling in pockets. Struggled a little bit, really enjoyed this page. And then from here on out, it was just feeling like I was so boring. Like, even though I'm telling my travel story, like, I found some cool enlargements, found some creative stuff to do, like attaching this photo to this, like, pamphlet that I had so that I didn't have to try to put it in a pocket or cut it up. So, like, I'm getting stuff done and it's matching the album, but I, like, sometimes you struggle and sometimes you lose your mojo. And I just, I'm trying to get this finished, but I'm trying not to have it, like, be disappointing and boring. So I'm kind of just taking my time. Like, I created this layout and then I went back in and I added the letters because I realized, you know, there's no information and I don't even really have a lot of spot for journaling right now. So this was the stuff that was on that layout. This is a new day. Flipping through here, like, it's just pockets filled. There's no journaling. There's no embellishments yet. I created this cool double page spread, which I thought looked really neat with, like, a big 12 by 12 photo. You know, and they're side by side. You can kind of tell. But just, like, you know, it's very, very simple. And I will be going back and adding more embellishments, but there's nothing that I felt like I needed to film here. And so what I did was I kind of went back to the beginning of the album and looked at things that, like, I really loved about it and how creative I was being. Like, when I started creating my daily page dividers where there was, like, a heart on it. And then I realized that this is a new page divider and I am using a map, but that I need something to distinguish it. Here again, I have more stuff stage. And then, like, with these puffy letters that were from this, my embellishments are flying everywhere. These puffy letters that I was using a ton of in the beginning, I hadn't used anywhere for, like, a long time. You know, I had used them on this, piece here, and on here, and on here. So, like, I had used several, and then there's a huge chunk of the album where I don't have anything at all. So I might put a transparency here and attach this one, maybe this one here. I'm still thinking about it. Right now, everything is still staged. I have some floral photos. This is all when we were in Carmel and driving down the PCH. I have another one here. So, like, whereas I felt super uninspired, even though I loved the photos, I finally remembered, oh yeah, this is the kind of stuff you were doing before, and that will help pull it together, and started making me a little bit more excited again. Here's another one I have staged. I have some of these pleather pockets, or sorry, pleather tags from the 2020 collection that I want to put in an outside pocket that was inspired by Allie's product play class for that. I have some empty pockets here. I have another one of these to fill. I have a lot of enlargements. That's more gaps I need to fill. And I'm finally through to the end of the album. So at least I know what I have left to work on. So I guess what I'm trying to say is, like, be encouraging. Don't be discouraged when you stumble, because it happens to everyone. Like I said, I've been taking my time trying to finish it. I was on vacation and I had to spend a lot of time getting photos edited. I really didn't have much for the whole, like, last third of the album. So I kind of had to plan all that. I'm going to add this tag here. I had a chipboard heart staged in there, but that's going to go there so that I use all the pleather tags in the album. But just, you know, and then I realized too, like, that this is a new day and it was a map, but it, like, in the beginning of my album, before I had really established anything, it was like an intro page, I'm flying page, the first few things that we did, an itinerary and a map, which are things I include in every album, but now this has also become a new page opener, and all my page openers have a heart. So, like, I'm gonna try to put this here, and I'm deciding between a handful of embellishments. Actually, let me shake those out, because they're pretty fun. Sometimes it's neat to see people's decisions, and it's kind of fun to decide what you would have put down. So I went through all my hearts. I'm definitely gonna stick with this blue in here. I had originally planned on this cork airplane, and I still might. It matches the cork geotags. It clearly shows that I was, like, flying, and, you know, to California, but it doesn't, you know, this was a flying layout back here. So it's like, I don't need a plane. We'll see. I also found this from the 2019 chipboard collection. It just is helping to pull in the colors of, like, the blue here and then this little bit of black there. It's dark blue, but it looks black. And then last, I have this brand new vellum heart, and I was thinking about layering two hearts here, and it says new adventure. This is from, I believe, the brand new transitions kit, and I thought that looked really cute because it had the black and the black, and I am actually thinking that that's what I'm going to lean towards, but it definitely will help you to, you know, so, like, sometimes it's easy just to keep going, but you also have to pause and look back and realize what formula was working for you and what will help give you continuity throughout the album. So that's kind of where I'm at now. I probably won't be filming too many more process videos just because I just have to get stickers down and pick chipboard, and nothing fancy is going on, nothing groundbreaking. But then when I'm finished, I will give a full walkthrough to the album. So I will be finishing up everything hopefully maybe tomorrow, which, like, today's a Saturday. I might work on it on a Sunday, get everything done, and sometimes I even like to sit with things and go back after a few days and see how it's looking. So, hope that this kind of explained a little bit about where I've been. Kind of motivates you for projects you're working on. Sometimes it's okay to power through. Sometimes it's okay to take a break. You just kind of have to decide what is, you know, what's going to work for you. And it sounds funny to say, but it's really true. So I'm excited to keep finishing it and try to get a little bit more consistency stuff done throughout the album so that it, you know, is complete all the way through. And then I will take a fresh eye and go back a couple times. Which is kind of part of my process. I'll add little embellishments, little stickers here and there, where I think things are missing. So thank you for watching and staying in, you know, support of me and watching my videos. Thanks so much.